So we're doing Madden Mondays here, watching the Dallas-Tennessee game. And, well, a little bit later, got something to eat and stuff like that. We'll be going in and playing the Play the Moments for probably about 4 weeks. So until we get to week nine, done with week nine, then we'll probably end up stopping there. Got to get up early tomorrow, got to vote. So, and voting for me starts at 6 before I go to work. So, let's start this bad boy up. Why we're doing it this way? Well, I kind of thought about it. Our Giants franchise is full games. And then we might do a coach, not a coach, but like a complete owner mode type deal. Where we just kind of stick with the team and we just watch the games. We'll watch a couple of years, things like that. It's a total sim franchise-wise. And then I want to play Bears franchise. So, critical third downs, two-minute drill, and red zone moments. So, let's do it. Never played Play the Moments. We're gonna play the moments.
Hey everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 19 on EA Sports.
All right, going up against
coming
the Bucs.
Fourth-year quarterback Jameis Winston and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers take on Mitchell Trubisky and the Chicago Bears. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football.
They're 0-3, and we're 3-0. Team,
Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
First opened way back in 1924, but renovated in 2002. There's a look inside venerable Soldier Field.
See what Jordan Howard can do.
This was the scene a moment ago as the Bears emerge from their tunnel. Ready for football are they, and ready for football are we as the Bears get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Bears team entering play. They've got to be pleased with the start to this season. Obviously, a perfect 3-0.
Anthony Miller had two touchdowns last week.
It's got people in the locker room excited. They're thinking that this could be their year.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Bucs, they come in 0-3 and in desperate, desperate need of a win.
And as a team, you start to feel a little bit snake bit. They need some.
All right. Yeah, Mitch to Anthony Miller. Whoops. 52-yard rush. The 52-yard touchdown. Let's go. Jameis Winston. Whoops. Jacquez Rogers. All right, they got a field goal there. Tariq Cohen. Mitch is sacked. Tariq Cohen for 24 yards. That one's thrown away. Anthony Miller. Trey Burton. It's third and eight, baby.
This defense already looking at a deficit on the scoreboard, but now what can they design here to disrupt this third down play?
Let's go, let's go. Let's go, let's go.
They run play action for Howard. Now Trubisky.
Ah.
And incomplete.
on the hands of Trey Burton.
Now Cody Parkey out to try the field goal. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And Parkey's kick is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays. Yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that.
All right. Winston, Evans, because Rodgers again. Back to bay by Roquan. Rodgers. 3rd and 4.
A pretty big early test for the defense coming up. What can they dial up here to try and thwart this third down situation? Winston from the game on third down. And he is tackled inside.
Well, we are going to play the full game with this. We're going to play the full game. We'll play the full game. How about it?
Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach, and you're tuned in to Madden 19 on EA Sports. Coming up, fourth-year quarterback Jameis Winston and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers take on Mitchell Trubisky and the Chicago Bears.
We're still going to this game.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to one of our favorite spots, venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Today, it's week 4, and we've got what should be a great one here between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Chicago Bears. Now it's Adam Humphries on the return.
Stop by Bucs.
On the return as they start their drive just past the 30-yard line. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. They're led out by a man raised in Alabama, went to Florida
State. All right.
State.
It's their come on, Jameis Winston.
Jameis Winston.
And it's funny how we always talk about how analytics are starting to creep into the game. One analytic that's been there for a long time, teams that start 0-3 usually don't make the playoffs. So we know one quarterback today that's determined to end that slide right now. It's not impossible, but this is a must-win for him and his team.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Jameis now on 1st and 10.
Roquan with that stop.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield. Goes deeper route, and then breaks it up. Usually after about 3 to 4 steps, he cuts towards the middle of the field, and now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
And a peek now at the offense for Tampa Bay.
And DeSean Jackson is the guy that your eyes naturally gravitate towards because he's a big play waiting to happen. In his career, usually averages about 20 yards a catch. Last season in 2017, closer to 13 yards per catch. Look for him to be recommitted to getting back downfield and catching the ball.
Nick Kupowski, which might be a viable option in our... Giants franchise.
Because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense,
if we need to upgrade middle linebacker,
because most teams like to be strong.
I've actually played through the season already, so I'll have to sum until after the season.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it.
How about the start time throwing the football. 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurate. In this case, though.
Oh, and then, oh, come on.
That's lost three straight games. Scoring first in this first quarter has to feel pretty good.
That's feel great for them, and also it's a nice signal to the rest of the team, because we talk about complimentary football all the time. So they've now signaled to the defense, now signaled to the kicking game, hey, we're here to play in this one. We're going to do our part. Let's see if you guys will do the exact same, and we can break this losing streak.
Extra point up and good by Catanzaro, and it's now a 7-0 game. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback.
Let's go. Let's do this, Mitch.
So here are the Bears now for their opening drive. And we get a peek at the former
5 touchdowns, 6 interceptions.
And I thought it was a really nice performance last week by him. 3 touchdown passes. I think that signifies exactly what he was getting done. He did have the 1 interception.
But that's the ratio you say you're okay with, right?
If you go 3-1, you're going to be pretty happy over the course of the season. And let's face it, he'll never blame the receiver publicly. But behind closed doors, he probably told his agent, hey, what's the deal? I should have had a perfect game.
Trubisky brings the Bears up 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Hey. 4 down.
And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Let's take
a look at the Bears offense.
At running back is Jordan Howard, who was an absolute revelation as a rookie, but he finished 2nd to Ezekiel Elliott for the rushing title in 2016. And no sophomore slump for him. Followed up his 2nd straight 1,000-yard season and finished 5th in the league.
There it is. Bowling over Chris Conte.
Buccaneer territory. A good run there on 1st down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2.
And that was a good run. This is only 1 of 9 guys to go over 1,000 yards in 2017.
Yeah. What did he do? Well, you think 100 yards to measure a skip?
That is the threshold. You want to keep him under that if you want to play.
1st down.
It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's 3rd down. Could be 4 down territory, even if they don't get this. But they need just a few inches here on 3rd. Now it's Trubisky.
That's in there, Anthony Miller. Good throw by Mitch.
Inside the 35. His 1st catch of the game, good for 11 and a 1st down. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on 3rd down, they did.
Big time pickup for them, and now, I think the aggressive play calls for themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed, makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
That is another 1st down.
It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. They're piecing together a nice drive to start this one. Seems pretty scripted.
The experience, see if we can give it out to Gabriel.
I think they did it without our help, because you remember when we sat in the production meeting with them to talk about this, and hey, you know, I think they come out of the game.
Now a throw to the end zone on 1st down, but it winds up incomplete.
Let's go.
Bears and Bucs, you might recall, met in Tampa week 2 of last year, which was actually the 1st game for the Buccaneers after Hurricane Irma washed out their opener with Miami. So it was the Bucs who beat Mike Glennon in that game 26-9. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain.
Go, go, go!
Given 4 on the ground there, they're now left with 3rd and 6.
And that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
They'll be in search of 6 yards here on third down. This is now the ninth play of the drive. Trubisky now off the bootleg. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. That's a
stupid throw.
Back. Now fourth down.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did it on the drive all the way downfield, but once it got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let them get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They struggle to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Okay, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of playbook trying to find one to get you into the end zone, get you six?
Here's Humphrey. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Now the Buccaneer offense gets set to take over. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know.
I need to play better defense.
If you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
I saw my ammo.
He is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just got it. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
550, 550! Ready! Blue ready!
Third short yardage, Winston. He's got it. He'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. First catch there for Evans. Good enough for a first down.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw.
Yeah, let's do this.
The first down. You kind of just feel a lot of focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw. When they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations, ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Had the offense humming on the first drive. Not much has changed here on drive number two.
No, and I think a lot of times confidence just really kicks in for a team. They may have been confident going into the game, but once you prove it on a drive, it's hard to get out of mindset. And let's face it,
come on, Roquan.
Of 100 yards, the two scores, and you know, you got to give a lot of credit to the A line. We talked a lot about him, but offensive line was good too.
There's no pressure from Mac this game either.
Zone blocking, power running game, no matter what, he understands how to read them and find the creases that they provide.
Oh, jumping early from his tight end spot. Maybe try to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. And oftentimes when you see that, that means the play call was supposed to come in his direction, and he was eager to go catch a pass.
Incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down. Yeah, he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic, and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Blue lady! Here we go!
Here we go! He'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple, down to the 15-yard line.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority. next level if you don't take care of him first.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Ready? Who ready?
Need to hold him here. He's out of bounds.
This is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. So erase the red zone score. They'll have to dial that one up again.
And you know how difficult it is to strike in the red zone because things are a little bit more condensed. You gotta go back to their play chart and see if they can dial up another one.
And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So unable to convert for the touchdown inside the red zone, but they do come away with three.
Yeah, it's a 32-yarder. That's essentially an extra point nowadays, right? Because it's 33 as a general rule for these guys. So it should be a simple kick. But you know what's really strange nowadays? When they miss an extra point, I think they carry that with them longer than missing a field goal, because an extra point's supposed to be automatic.
Absolutely, and I would think even field goals inside of 30 yards, even though they're substantially shorter than a PAT, it just has a different feel, doesn't it?
A different feel, a different vibe. That's what I get from all the kickers I talk to. They always say, if I miss an extra point, that's the one that bothers me.
Good punch.
Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now Trubisky. Forced out to his left. Space to maneuver at the 40. That is slide down to avoid the contact. At the end of one, 10-3 the score. And we're back to Soldier Field after this. And they've got it here with a first down.
Let's go.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already.
Maybe had Shaheen open if I threw it up, but
they'll throw on first down with Trubisky. Underneath to his linebacker, complete. And he'll take it down shy to 45 at the 46. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll make it second and short.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
This is now on second down. Gets this inside the 35-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time, and a flush shut it down.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, three plays, three first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, take it to the end zone real fast.
Gerald McCoy coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about nine. And an early sack there for Tampa Bay. Charles, that is a welcome sight.
A sight for sore eyes, you might say, right? Just 22 sacks in the season in 2007. Breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, They almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Damn.
Let's go now. Three team, come on.
You can go to each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. On the return, it's Tariq Cohen. Yards up to the 27-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that.
We always hear about empty possessions. Some are worse than others.
Throw it away.
Empty possession, pump the ball away. Did you suck up with our defense? But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Second and 10 is Trubisky again. Looking like somebody's got a man. It's Martin. He's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. Here he runs now. Out of the gun. First down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
If indeed the Chicago Bears are looking for a nice change up to Jordan Howard at running back, they found it in Tariq Cohen. I'm telling you, this guy is shifty, quick, even though he's small in stature. Some people call him just a human joystick.
How about that? That'll be
Let's go.
He's just 5'6", but as you said, he can move. A gain of 6 there on first.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. As he dragged across each zone, you see a pointing communicating. There he is, and it passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
So many teams want to throw it in this ball situation nowadays, but I love watching.
They haven't really stretched the just the field all day either.
He's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
On second down, Trubisky. Trubisky to Gabriel there for Bears first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Now Trubisky. Trubisky.
What am I doing? Come on. Step straight up in the pocket.
So they'll keep possession. So they escape. So
this isn't Eli Manning.
Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That would be a little bit deflating. Exactly right. A lost opportunity.
I think we had an open guy on the outside. We did. Look. streaking down the sideline. He comes open right here. I thought right there, he's there.
Pass play there, but it's incomplete. The Bears on third.
Do a variant to that play. We have another out. Oh, this is the same play. My bad.
Scramble good for a nice gain of 10 yards, but still fourth down.
Well, it's not going to be a first down, but that's a nice job of picking up yardage on third and long. Sometimes you just have to take what the defense gives you, and in this case, it wasn't enough to pick up the first down.
No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Parkey now following the made field goal to kick this one off. They will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now. The field goal line feels like a disappointment. Together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They got to feel pretty good about that one.
We'll remind you once again, coming up at halftime, we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He's got stats and scores from around the NFL as we wrap up the first month of the season.
No longer is he a rookie.
A familiar ring to that one. Winston to Evans for the Buccaneer first.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there.
Ready.
It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it.
Oh, come on, Nick.
A disaster there on the check down, but they'll get it back.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play right in his hands.
Nice work, Juan.
This is going to be incomplete. The tight end Cameron Blake was the target. And it's third down. That is the first time that they've targeted him that he has not come down with a catch.
He's caught everything that's been thrown his way. A dominant pass receiver that can break down any defense because when he's doing that kind of work, it really hurts you on the back end.
And even though it's an incompletion error, I think you're going back to that play. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On third down, here's Brian Angle now to kick this one away. Back deep, Tariq Cohen. Just 21 yards on the punt there. And the Bears take over. Jordan Howard and the rest of the offense heading back out there. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter.
Dude being in an isolation on the outside.
I think that what you're trying to do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out more open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call on the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah. Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game, because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here? This is Trubisky, and he comes back with one complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. On first and 10, it's Trubisky.
Oh!
That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. This is Carter. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him, though. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Now a play fake here on first down. Now he's going to throw it back deep.
Come on, you got to come up down with that ball.
Seconds to go in the first half. Trubisky now 9 of 16 through the air as he's got it first and 10. From the shotgun is Trubisky.
Touchdown! Let's go! Let's go!
Seconds, all that remains for this first half as they come up first and 10.
Ready, white 25.
Now Rodgers. He'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and 1. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Buccaneers out on top. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone. A lot to get to here this final day of September. So let's get started. We'll start up in Lambeau, Buffalo, in town to take on Green Bay. And it's the Packers who are in front in the second quarter. Randall Cobb. A touchdown reception.
There's Josh Allen up there,
there
playing
let's
Buffalo,
hop
too.
Over to New England. Check out the Patriots at home in Foxborough.
Brady, three TDs in the first half.
Tom Brady added
again. Tannehill can't get anything
three
going.
Touchdown passes. Finally, we'll save the biggest for last as we head to AT&T Stadium to see what's happening with the Cowboys at home in Arlington. And they have the lead in that one over the visiting Lions. Two touchdown passes there for Dak Prescott. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Bucs with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. So here's the Bears offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a
halfback toss towards Gabriel's side?
Within striking distance like this of intermission.
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of those. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason for that. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half. Punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
Sometimes those lines that are drawn on a grease board or in a playbook, they come to life. I like the field, don't they? We just saw that on the outside hand off to the right.
That right tackle, he gets excited for that call, doesn't he?
He does, because he just wants to
get it. Good throw.
Exactly where you're exit points are going to be. On this play, it was flushed to his left, still on the run.
Nice one by Gabriel.
No matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the different targets.
Here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run.
I am, and you know I'm in school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me an option of running play action, maybe throwing it.
Damn, we came out of nowhere.
But no further than that. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal.
We got three. He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. The target's covered. 4 yards, that gets him close to the goal line, but it also brings up a fourth and goal.
We're going to do another toss the outside with Cohen's speed. Cohen's speed's in there. Quick set up and go.
A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Bears are in for six. So they went for it from the one on fourth and goal. And they got it done.
Is this the new NFL?
This is the new NFL.
This is the updated NFL. And I like it. I know the quarterbacks across the league has spent the entire offseason and even during the season lobbying their coaches to go for it more on fourth down. Let's go get it. Because nowadays, you got to score points to win games in the NFL. You can't just rely on your defense to hold
it. I think the quarterbacks want to eliminate field goals inside of 30 yards, probably.
But listen, they have enough confidence in themselves that they can call plays and make plays that they won't need those field goals inside the 30.
Here's Parkey now, set to kick it away. Here's Humphreys.
That's a good tackle by Bush.
Here at the 30-yard line. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them.
You're Storm Brave. I like to call this.
How they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script on those?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. But in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Let's go now.
Jameis now. 14 out of 17, 82%, and it's first and 10.
Ready! Ready!
And a first carry here for Charles Sims. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
This time with Jones. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Jones.
Broke one.
Short gain down to about the 33. And on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball.
Ready! Watch me
back! And now that's running down to the 32. Big Eddie Goldman there on the tackle.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man.
Yeah,
he is well over 300
pounds. Ooh, dropped it.
To just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And that's going to tie things at 20. So they come away from this opening drive in the third quarter with only three, but it does draw them even.
Yeah, that has to be job one, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's not a ball game. Definitely would have been nice. Let's put this one in the bag.
You get back on even terms, and they get most of the second half to try and get yourself into a position to win.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
Good hard run there by Howard.
They're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run, and vice versa. I would continue that. And when they finally just beat on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit with play action and throw the ball.
Come on, gotta go, gotta go.
Will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. They run play action for Howard. Now Trubisky. Rolling to his left. Almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive
pattern
reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it. People call it dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear.
Oh, come on, White.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. With it is Jackson. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. Well, at least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT. Right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the other.
Cooler there. Backing away.
I've met a fan base yet that wants to drive down with a kick. Other than the extra point. That's it.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10.
Ready. Back to the front. Here you go.
Smith turns on Mac there.
He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and 8 forthcoming.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outside of the strike.
And misses it.
It's going to be incomplete.
Had an open man that time. They end up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Here's Brandon Anger now. As he'll punt it away for the second time.
What kind of spin was that?
52-yard punt, not too shabby. And it'll be first and 10 Bears from deep in their own territory. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down.
We go!
Looking to throw Trubisky on first down. Work to get settled on the ground, and it's second down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. On second down, here's Trubisky. He's got a dump that out to his right corner. And able to break one tackle.
I wanted to go to Kevin White on that, but.
Call it a 1-yard gain on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
The Bears on third.
See if you can get this to Cohen and get this.
2 for 6 thus far. This time they face a 3-2.
And the move outside. That was a nice one.
That's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Shoulders just dropped there, and what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Green go deep
forward, another quick drive. They go play action here on first down. Is it
damn it?
A scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield, but that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit. And then they have to change the
play. Let's go with a Burton tight spot. Good throw.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Trubisky finding the former Eagle Burton for the Chicago first.
And this offense can get their tight ends involved. They can move the football. Here, a nice route.
Oh, Gabriel, that spin move. Flip up the pocket, throw that good ball in there. Going by Howard, man. Good running.
Excited. I'll guarantee the guy throwing the ball does, because guess what? He's got a lot of options about where to place it because of Mike Evans' size.
Winston.
Almost picked it off. Benny Jackson, come on.
A great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Good job sifting through those tackles for Roquan.
Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Partner, we know today's NFL really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes on.
Back now at Soldier Field. It's Buccaneer football, but they've got work to do. They find themselves behind here to start the fourth quarter.
Blue lady! Where's that up?
fourth and inches.
Some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Ready.
Oh, and it's going to be Floyd with the stop in the backfield.
Keep the sticks moving, right? Keep the clock going.
On the line now. And that's a good snag there by Kevin White. We haven't gotten him too involved today.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Wonder if my
do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
Wonder if my other franchise that the Bears signed Jordan Howard.
And he's able to get it down to the 2 yard line. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant, a lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of one, and that is going to set up third and goal.
Get in there. Touchdown. Mitchell Trubisky. Let's go. Let's go.
That was not a designed run. It was supposed to be a pass, but it turned into an exceptional run. What a scramble for a touchdown.
Now parking for the extra point. Parkey with the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. That time a 6-play drive, and it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. Here's Parkey now set to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned him 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused every
bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for it. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure they only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself the play calling. Don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second would even matter.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
Ready. Move it.
A
First down throw for Winston. He gets Rodgers in the corner. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 12 yards on back-to-back plays there, and that's another first down.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up. They've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? Evans has it right side. 11 more on that one, and another first down. Winston in the offense with a first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive.
Ready! Blue ready!
We get some pressure by Mack here.
They'll throw again. Winston. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that.
Here we go straight to a man.
Congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Look like an eye.
We're back to the zone on next cover.
Out of Orlando, Florida. Absolute mess. Now Winston. For the sideline, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete.
To admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, you have toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
Great job by our crew on the camera shot. And this is taken in at the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Try some by Roquan.
They see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield.
Took a different size than they used to see in Chicago playing the middle linebacker position. But undersized or not, his speed is absolutely overwhelming. He arrives with the ball. He's sitting on his shoulders. This is Roquan Smith.
Nice pick up there. He gets about 5 down to the 4-yard line.
Sometimes I get caught in hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, 2-score game, second half. You're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
Man, not going to get much better than this for an opportunity.
Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucs may have moved. Maybe anticipating a blitz, and they jumped.
Yeah, and if we saw it, you know that they saw it. The bad guys might have been coming on that play. Had to pick them up, and they jumped.
A bad time for a false start penalty as they're backed up now for third and goal.
Everyone, come forward. Ready. Blue ready. Right, head up.
Roquan is on tackle.
He'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down. Well, look at the clock. You're down 2 scores. Have to go for this, don't you?
And they thought that as soon as they took over possession. It didn't matter where they were on the field. He's going to be in third down territory.
He's out.
But cannot push forward into the end zone, and it'll be a turnover on downs. So now with a 2-minute warning coming up fast, that puts a mammoth dent in their comeback hopes.
I like how you phrased it. It's a dent because there's still opportunity. They've got to keep the ball back on defense, obviously, twice. This thing is not close to being over. They need to go ahead and
first down.
As you said, 2-score game still. Trying to escape the shadow of their goalpost. That half, 10 yards, first down. And what do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense. Use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. Time for a break. He'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. And a nice game there. It's going to be taken down just shy of the 20. And now right out of the 2-minute break,
We'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. On third down.
And one more first down.
To go. We get another pause in the action. Timeout here defensively. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Stop! I need it!
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. And a short game there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. As they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So second and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. Now it's Trubisky. And
what?
Complete. Now loose ball. The ball comes in, and the Buccaneers make it.
I'm guessing that on the sidelines, there might be a few words said about that mistake there, but I don't think it's going to hurt them in the long run. They're still going to get out of here with a win.
Yeah, they got the two-score cushion, but you know what coaches say, Charles? Finish strong.
Finish the game out the way it's supposed to be played. In fact, coaches might be secretly happy. Give them a chance to do a little extra coaching next week.
Winston now after the fumble recovery. And they'll get this down to the 10. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. First down now, but that clock rolling.
5 on 50.
Jameis now on first down.
There it is. Khalil Mack. Finally getting a sack, man.
Khalil Mack. In there to drop it as the clock continues to roll. Second down. One step.
Bounce.
That one out of bounds. Out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack.
We got this one in the bag, so it's not really a big issue.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. No, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
You got to think this is likely four down territory anyway, but they'll try to punch it in now on third and goal. From the shotgun, it's Winston.
Just fooling with the tackle.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. They wind up with six on the hook up there, but it's not enough. Fourth and goal. Desperation time. Winston on fourth down.
Wow, that went through the hands of Kyle Fuller.
Late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
And there's going to be a stoppage here. The booth wants to take another look at this potential touchdown.
I think he has that catch. Yeah, he does.
Technology is for, and this touchdown will count. Extra point good by Catanzaro. So a little under 50 seconds to go. Plenty of time if they can get this onside kick. They're on to the fourth quarter in Jacksonville. And it was the Jaguars who were able to come away with a victory there. Leonard Fournette, two touchdowns on the ground to help lead the way. The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field.
Oh, this looks, it's an end around to Gabriel. Let's see if we can pull it off. They've done it. It didn't end around in this game before.
In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone.
All right, we're just going to.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to
time. It's going
to
QB Neal.
You can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
Four down.
That'll be in the game.
Just around the corner. They go down to a knee.
scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know people who love this game, they also love baseball games that are 14-11 with three or four home runs mixed in.
So for Chicago, hey, they finish a perfect month of September as they move to 4-0.
They get any takeaways, but 216 yard rushing.
Before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for Tampa Bay, they'll sink now to 0-4. And fortunately for them, they'll have the early bye next week as they return to action in week 6. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL.
We threw a turnover. 19-30. Rushing. Howard had 118. Cohen had 58. Both of them had a touchdown apiece. And Trubisky had a touchdown, too. All right. Receiving. Gabriel. Miller. Miller had a touchdown. Brate. Sean Jackson at 2. Only 4 sacks this game. That's what happens when you have a legit offensive line. All right, Kyle Fuller. So man coverage, that went up. That's pretty nice. We'll start the backup. Who's Anthony Miller? Who have I signed so far on the team? Hey, Goldman, Amos, okay. Scout the college players. We get Trevathan back. We get Allen Robinson back. I think Roquan will be good here. No, I'm just gonna sim. Okay, let's see. All right, guys, I'm going to end this stream here. Got up earlier to vote and go to work, so this will be up on YouTube. So I will see you guys later. Tomorrow we'll be streaming instead of Wednesday. I don't know what we're going to pull up. Maybe some BattleTech. So maybe we'll do that. So I will see you guys later.